God loves you.
The children react as if you're Santa Claus and it's Christmas. And I say, are you ready to get some coats? And they go, yay!
Let's go. Let's go.
Christmas presents came early to Armenia. 11 remote villages, coats, hats, and boots for 400 children. Time for celebration. This was the fifth mission for Coats for Carrie's Kids. It started with tragedy in 2003.
It began when my daughter was hit head-on in a traffic accident in Uzbekistan.
Carrie's Coats got started sort of as a way for Carl and I to get over our grief.
Carrie Doolin was a missionary in Armenia, working with kids in orphanages and schools in the rugged mountain communities.
Carrie mentioned to us several times that some of the kids out in the villages just couldn't even go to school because they didn't have coats and boots.
She told me that the buildings weren't heated, so when it got so cold, kids would stay at home because they could stay warm in their beds.
It's a good way to honor my sister because she spent 6 years of her life there.
Carrie was baptized, confirmed, and memorialized at Doylestown United Methodist.
It was a trying time for us when the tragedy happened to Carrie.
For years, the United Methodist women in Doylestown sewed hats for the mission trips.
We really, truly enjoyed knowing that we were helping some of Carrie's children because we considered them a part of Carrie.
Reverend Doolin bought coats and boots locally. Altogether, Carrie's friends and church family donated $22,000 for this mission.
I think Carrie would be very proud of us. In fact, I know she is, because she's with us when we're over there.
I'll tell you a story. There was one kid left there, and there were no coats. And it was just like God was tapping me on the shoulder. And so we gave him mine. And the mayor said, you know, everybody's going to see him in that coat, and he's going to remember you. And I said, well, let him remember the United Methodist Church. I could just feel Christ's presence. And that's a wonderful feeling.